Okay, so the inspector left out. Let me show y'all this first. It's a little dark in here, so you can't really see it. But basically, that says that I'm okay to insulate. So the inspector had a lot of different things that he wanted to see that were done. For instance, this wall right here, when you push on it, you can see that the sheathing moves a little bit. So he wants that tightened up. There's going to be a lot of draft blocking that we're going to have to do. The draft blocking is basically covering in holes. See that daylight that's right here by that pipe? So if there was a fire down in the basement, this would allow the fire to come up to the first floor. You don't get any burn time if there's a hole. So draft blocking is basically filling in that hole with either insulation or drywall or wood, something that will give you more of a burn time. So we gotta work all this out. Every 10 feet on the wall, we need to have another kind of draft blocking going across here. So, if you start the wall over here, you measure the whole way around, come around this corner, and then down here, and somewhere around here, you're at 10 foot. So he would want all of this like foamed up and blocked. So it's a little bit hard to explain right now, but I'll probably do some time-lapse videos while I'm doing the work. And that way y'all can see what's going on and know what to expect whenever you're on your projects. So the draft blocking is mad time consuming. If you were paying someone to do it would probably be kind of expensive because it's a lot of man hours. So looking at all of this, all of these are chase ways that the fire could come up. And even these little holes that go through from the electrician, those holes would allow, let's say that this wire right here went bad and caused a fire. The fire would burn straight up and, go out the roof. Unless you have holes like this where, the fire could spread to more bays. Okay, I'm trying to remember this because he was just explaining it to me as we were walking through. But from what he was saying, each one of the bays goes straight up to the roof, right? So it goes the whole way up. And if you don't have draft blocking going from bay to bay, then the fire can spread behind the walls and you don't really know where the fire is at. So whenever the, firemen come in to try to put it out, they're poking holes everywhere just trying to figure out where the fire is originating from. So that draft blocking helps out with stuff like that. So we got a little bit of work to do to get it together, but we're ready to put the insulation up. A lot of these holes will get covered in once the insulation's in. So, like what I was saying about the stairs, those will get covered with the insulation. So we're looking pretty good. I'm trying to think of like what else we have to do. We still got some soffit work. You can see all that daylight up there. We got to block that out. But for the most part, he was pretty impressed with how it turned out. These vents. So you see how the plumber ran this vent going up and then he drilled through the, I don't know, the studs, the wall studs. You're supposed to have 50% of your stud left, which there's not. If you don't, then you have to have a special brace that goes around it and clamps onto it. So I have to get those braces and work that out, which will be hard to do since the pipes are already there. But we gotta figure out something. So there's a couple little things that he noticed that he wanted me to take care of. But, as inspectors go, he was pretty happy with it. So that works out well because I was definitely worried about this area right behind. All right, so the battery died at the site. I'm over here at the townhouse. I didn't take into consideration how long my battery was going to last, and I had the camera blocked, so I thought I recorded the rest of the video, but I really didn't. Long story short, at this point in the project, our 1613 project, I have the draft blocking to do, I have sheathing, and I have notching. Now, that being said, the inspector already gave us the okay to insulate. So I'll just take care of those things as I'm insulating. He'll come out one more time to check the insulation to make sure that I took care of those three different issues that he had mentioned. And once all of that's done, then he'll give me the okay to put the drywall up. So I talked to the drywall hangers, and I could have a crew come through on the 18th and 19th of May to hang the whole thing. Now that's a huge point for any project. And I am very relieved to be to this point because this thing has been expensive. Oh my God. All right, but it's the end of the day. I gotta get up early for the gym and you know, do it all again, all over tomorrow. So keep on grinding, like, subscribe, and I'll catch y'all on the next video.